is God partial?
There are families where the women, the mother of the family, is praying and asking God not to give her more children. Then you walk into another home and they are asking for just one. Sometimes it looks as if God is partial. It looks as if God is partial in his dealings, in his works, in his attribute as a God. That's why some people said this life is not balanced. This subject is in relation to mankind. We're dealing with mankind, the dealings of God with certain individuals, with all humanity. What did God see in Abraham that he chose him? Was he the only son? Why did God create Adam? Why didn't he create Christ? Why was his name Adam? Why didn't he make you? Maybe you probably wouldn't have even... Why did he even make Eve? Why didn't he make Kemi? Are you with me? So sometimes it looks as if God is partial. Please, write it there. Jesus knows all men. Write it. It is the basics of what we want to share. This is the foundation I'm showing you. Jesus, the Bible just showed us now, he knows all men. So everybody, from Adam to the last person that will be born, Jesus knows everybody. That means God knows everybody. He knew that people were going to ask this kind of question. In considering or answering the question, if God is partial, there are a couple of things I want you to take notice of that we must answer during the course of this. Number one, does God owe us any explanation as to why he does the things he does? Does he owe human an explanation as to why he does the things he does? The things he do as a God, does he owe us any explanation? So if I decide to leave Sister Yetunde and send her to America to become a billionaire, do I owe you, Emma, an explanation as to why? Because humans are wired like that. They want you to give them reasons as to why you do the things you do. Number two, the second thing you must consider when we are asking this question, is God partial, is this. Are you sure that the reason for asking this is not greed? And if so, what is greed? Number three, as we consider and answer the question, is God partial, we will consider this also. What about divine contentment? These are the questions, the things we are going to consider. Are you following me? What about divine word? Contentment. Number four, Abi. The number four question is this. Why do you want more? Why do you want more? Like, why do you really want more? Number five. In answering this question, is God partial, we will consider the pleasures of God and his desires and will. We will consider the pleasures of God and his desires and his will. You must understand that amidst this revelation of his word, the power of his word, there is such a thing as the mind of God. All of God's mind is not generic. It's not written in the word. There's the mind of God for Sister Chiso. There is the mind of God for Pastor Esther. Do you find Pastor Esther in the Bible? Is Chisomi in the Bible? I've read the Bible many times. I've never even seen Chi, not talk of some. But there is the mind of God for Amara, for Gbemi. Number six, we're also going to consider the election of God by grace. Do you know how many weeks all this one will take? The election of God by grace. The last one, number seven, is that not it? Knowing the end from the beginning. So he says, but our God is in the heavens. He had done whatsoever he had pleased. He had done whatsoever he had pleased. It is the things that pleases him. He does whatever he pleases. The only thing that David did not include here is that the things he does, which are the things that pleases him, should be according to his will. Because if you say he does what he pleases without including according to his will, then it will mean that God can wake up and decide that your first son is dying today. And that is the religious teaching. That's not God. God does not decide to kill your son. Are you getting me? but he does whatsoever he pleases according to his will. It is according to his will. He told the prophet, you know what he told the prophet? He said, I am God. I can change. I change times and seasons. I lift a man up and I remove one. He does whatsoever that pleases him. But I want you to know one thing, that God will not look at a man who is functioning according to his will and mind and lift him out and put another one there. No. So long and as long as the man functions and does the things that pleases him, he retains him.